I'm Bill Fry. I'm the president of the Florida Sheriff Youth Ranches. I've been working for the ranches since 1985. And I've been working here with the camp. I was with the camps from 1989, I think, up until like 2000 that I lived on this campus here at Barberville. So it goes way back for me being here. I raised my daughter here. My wife and I raised our kids and basically raised a lot of kids when you get right down to it.
My name is Courtney and I have been with the camp for a year so far.
I'm Thomas Bryant. I've been working with the youth ranches going on 3 years now.
My name's Jake. I'm going into my third year here at the camp.
Hi, I'm Autumn Baez.
Today is kind of just all about like thanking the people that make the camp happen. A lot of people here are donors and have given us the money to bring kids here, order t-shirts, pay the workers, and are really the reason that we're here. Obviously, the focus of the camp is the kids, but without the donors, we wouldn't have the kids. So it's really about just giving back and letting them see all the passion and the work that goes into this camp.
So what does this day mean to me? This day means to me it's a fellowship. It's people gathered together who believe in a common cause, and that's to support children.
The significance for this day is it helps bond with the kids and with my fellow counselors and really get to know everyone who helps out around and possible donors and just thank them for contributing and making this camp amazing.
During this day, we have cornhole over there. We have a thing called trash can jam. We have a lot of good food to eat. A lot of people come over to the dock. They pretty much catch up. Our president comes here and gives a speech about the ranches and why this organization is so great. And it's just another way to just get people out here and have fun, show them, you know, what we can do. We have a big field out there that we usually play football at, or we have water day and stuff like that. So we just want to try to use all of our resources out here today.
Honestly, I'm a huge outdoors person. I love any opportunity I can get to work outdoors. And that's what it was initially for me, but what kept me coming back was definitely the kids.
Well, I was looking for my first job, and my friend Justin was saying that Miss Malott needed people, and I knew Miss Malott because she was my brother's band teacher when he was young. So there was already a connection there, and it just felt like home.
Funny enough, I actually started off doing it as an internship. It came to my college and my professor was like, hey, like you really like kids and there's a lot of opportunity with law enforcement, you should check it out. So I checked it out, I reached out to Daniel Phillips and had an interview with him at Starbucks after the gym. It was very casual, talked to him about it, and then like right from there I was like, wow, this seems really cool. I really like the mission statement. This camp is free for a lot of kids, so a lot of these kids aren't paying for a week of fun. They really don't know what they're getting themselves into. We don't do this because of the money, we do this because of the kids, and that's what I learned very quickly.
I think that I wanted to leave a sense of passion. I mean, everyone that works here has a passion for the children and for what we do, but everyone has their own unique take on that, and I want to leave my personal take.
If I had to leave a footprint, it would probably be the heart that I give to this camp. As far as you come to this camp and you realize that it's just not a normal camp. It's a camp that you leave during the school year and you're like, man, I want to come back. So the footprint I want to leave is like hard work and dedication will fuel you in the future with this camp.
That's a good question to ask, because here's the thing, there's a lot of research and you know, we have our outcomes, our positive outcomes, and we do pre and post questionnaires when kids come to camp, when we do our leadership programs. But there are three things though that if you look up and you can find it, these are three positive things that happen at summer camp. And if people go, what can you do in a week? Well, here are the things that research based that you can do in a week. Number one is you can improve a child's self-esteem. That's their belief in themselves, all right? That's believing who they are. That's them liking themselves, self-esteem. The second thing is self-confidence, their belief that they can do something, they can accomplish something. We have a ropes course, we have nature, we have trails here, we do swimming and canoeing and all the things, but it's that ability to take a risk, to jump outside of your little cocoon and take that risk, getting that self-confidence. We promote that, and camp develops that. The last thing is social skills, how to interact with other people. A lot of the kids that come to us, some of them have been latchkey kids. They don't really have social skills. They don't know how to positively interact. And a week of summer camp can make that change. Now, that if they go into our residential programs, that even, you know, that they overcome a lot more boundary issues and a lot more difficulty. In fact, if they graduate high school with us and they want to go to a vo-tech program or a college, we'll pay for it. I have 17 kids on full college scholarship. I've even had kids graduate from Flagler and Stetson.